Outside, as you can see, we're so close to the water, and in a way, the trees, the grass, the water, the sky, the birds are part of also this installation done by Arturo Herrera. Arturo Herrera is an artist that is from Venezuela, but he lives in Berlin, and he did this installation, which I think is very connected to our nature here in Miami. I'm Rosa de la Cruz, and I live in Key Biscayne, Florida. I'm a person that has multiple activities. I consider myself an activist, but also my family is very important to me. Even though this house, it's my home, it's actually my husband Carlos and I, we live here, it has become a very public space. It's really a new way of living. Some people, when they come here, they wonder, how can we live in a house where we allow people to come and see the collection and walk through our private spaces? But in a way, it's something that in life you can choose. It's choosing this way of life was because we thought that our collection meant a lot for a lot of people in our town. And they really wanted to come and see it. And I thought, why shouldn't we open our house to them? Anyone can email us and ask to come to the house. We just tell them, you know what I mean, give them a date and make a reservation for them. Felix Gonzalez Torres is here in the center of the house. This is sort of like the atrium of the house. And he's an artist that has been very important for our collection. And Felix was an artist that he believed that concepts are more important than objects. This fantastic work of his is probably one of the works in our collection that, to me, really is the soul of the collection. That Felix Gonzalez Torres understood that life is not about one reality, it's always about two. I mean, you can't think that your reality and the other reality are not valid. They're both equally valid. My place, your place, that's what it's saying. In this room has a magic light in here, and I always keep this work here. It's sort of people come and they see the other works around the space changing, but this is sort of like where you start to view the collection. With Felix Gonzalez Torres and Jim Hodges, this mirror, you look at yourself and you're fragmented. So again, this idea of diversification, of more than one, of not keeping ourselves to ourselves. We have to split ourselves. We have to become and understand the other. When we started collecting, it was very different from now. At first, I never thought that we were going to collect and remove all the furniture from the house. This house is close to 2,000 square meters and only one bedroom, and the rest is all for the art. Our collection at first was more focused in Latin American art. With time, we decided that we really had to move into the contemporary art scene. Carlos and I, we decided to move into the 21st century. We're looking at the future, and I'm willing to accept new ideas. I always say that art doesn't have to fulfill your agenda. is not about an agenda. It's about accepting that things are going to change whether you want it or not. And sometimes people say, well, I don't understand that. Well, you don't have to understand it either. There's some questions that have no answers. But most people, you know, they sort of want art to respond to their needs. And I think art, really, you have to be able to open up. What we eat, and you can see it has this huge head by Christian Holstad. He placed it here on top of our dining room. I said, Christian, how are we gonna eat? But in a way, you can't eat. You just move all this. You can move all this tentacles, whatever, around you. And I think this is a fantastic image because Christian Holstad comes from that very American tradition of crafts, of quilting. And you see how he takes fabric and has created this head. Also, even though it's in capsule, it's celebrating because it has all these champagne glasses. And it's, I mean, when you sit under this head, you feel like you're sitting under the world. It almost looks like a huge globe. Art to be closer to the people. I think that art cannot be elitist, even though it does have to be elitist in terms of quality. Art cannot be possessed. I mean, there's no way that I can say I own my collection. I'm just a guardian of this works. The light here is sort of special. It's like, that's one thing that everybody asks me when they come here. Why is it that there's this light here? The light, it's sort of like, you feel like you're in a dream light, in a dreamlike situation. I think it's this color of the sky and the color of the sea meeting together. So we're so close to both of them. And that's what this house reflects. This house is in an area that usually you wouldn't see an art collection. The magic of the place is here, year round. And that's what I think most people see. There's a magic in Miami, and of course the collection by the water, it's even more.